Welcome to another edition of Some Arts, and I'm glad to be joined with Nina Eichner once again. Hello.
Hi. Hello.
How are you doing?
I'm amazing.
Yes, you are. Yes, you are. That's the perfect answer to that.
Thank you. There's a lot going on.
There is a lot going on. Very typical for this time of year for you all.
Yeah.
You're coming off of some busy weekends. You're coming into some busy weekends and weeks, like events during the week.
Yes.
And we can actually start off talking about an event during the week next week, August 22nd.
Correct.
There's a talk with some new muralists over at the East Somerville Public Library.
Yeah.
Why don't you share some details?
I heard that you're moderating that talk.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's great.
I will be there moderating this talk.
Yeah.
So who are the three muralists this year?
So as you remember, last year we had three muralists come in and do these street art style murals in the city, and they were amazing. It was super exciting to have them, and people comment all the time how much they love these murals. And this was actually a directive from the mayor to have more physical public art in the city. And we're really appreciative that he kind of pushed for that idea and we were able to execute it. So this year we're having three new muralists come. And actually, one of them lives in Somerville, so she is not coming from far. She's a resident. Her artist name is Imagine. She's a Nepali artist, and she lives in Somerville and has been doing amazing murals all over the world, but a bunch in, there's one, a recent one in Central Square in Cambridge, one in Worcester. And her work mixes traditional Sanskrit writing with the graffiti style, which is really cool. And she'll be doing, actually, her piece will be right at the corner of Webster and Prospect Ave, right up the hill here.
Very cool.
And so that's happening. She's one of our artists. The second is this artist, Pascal. He's from Haiti. And he's coming here to do a mural in partnership with Highland Creole Cuisine, which is the Haitian restaurant up near the public library.
Mm-hmm.
And we're really excited to have him. And our third artist is this artist named Kaolo, who lives in Philadelphia. He's Salvadorian, and he does a lot of paintings to do with figure painting, but also kind of nature and plants, and often using a lot of the references for the plants are from El Salvador and other places in Central America and South America. And so we're super excited to have him. So all three of them are really amazing. I am excited to meet the ones I haven't met yet.
Yeah.
And on August 22nd from 6 to 8 at the East Somerville Branch Library, we'll be having a talk with them. And last year it was so interesting to hear the inspiration behind their artists, you know, why they do the work that they do, their backgrounds and their history. And this year we really wanted to make sure that the artists we were working with reflected the diverse cultures and, people who live in Somerville, and so we particularly wanted to work with people from communities that have large representations here. So we're really excited to have all three of these artists.
That's great.
Yeah.
And I love that that kind of thought went into the selection of these artists and the linking Central American history with Somerville history and Haitian history with Somerville history. That's awesome.
Absolutely.
So looking forward to that. And then a couple of days after that, we have this amazing
This beautiful,
event here.
This gorgeous poster that you see behind us is by Ariel Gray, who's a writer for BUR, or works for BUR doing arts programming, and she's also a graphic designer. And the festival is in partnership with Oompa, who's a local rapper and artist. And we've worked with her on past events, and we asked her to co-produce this because as a queer black woman and someone who's really involved in the art scene in Boston, we really wanted to get her perspective on this community, and also she's just been a good partner to the Arts Council, and she helped us curate an amazing lineup for this festival, which we're super excited about. We're also going to have visual artists there, and the thinking behind the event is that, as Oompa put it, there's often places for queer people and people of color, and it often feels like you can't bring both of those identities to one place together. And she was really excited about the opportunity to have a space that connects those two, and I feel really lucky at the Arts Council to be able to support that type of work happening and to support someone like her who's so such a talented artist to bring all these other artists together.
Makes total sense, especially as you have somebody like planning a straight pride festival in Boston.
Totally, a weekend after this,
Yeah, it seems like no, wait, there's a need for pride events.
Absolutely.
There's a need for singling out representation in this way.
Yeah.
And it's not a joke. It's not a punchline.
Right, exactly.
And it's necessary. And this is awesome. This is great.
Yeah.
Looking forward to that.
Yeah, I'm really excited. So that's 3 to 7 on August 24th. And like you said, I think one of the things that the city and the Arts Council can do because of the resources we have as a city government is to provide platforms and spaces to people whose voices are less often in the mainstream or less often given a platform. Mm-hmm. And so I think this is a great example of that. And like you said, there's some kind of thinking these days of like, we don't need that, everybody's cool with everything and we're liberal in Massachusetts and that kind of sentiment. And I think it is important to be intentional about who we're creating spaces for. And
I think now more than ever.
Absolutely.
Awesome. So that's August.
That's August.
For the Somerville Arts Council.
Yeah.
And then we jump right into September. Mm-hmm. And what's your first September event?
So we have a triple header weekend, which isn't shocking, but it's a little more than usual for the Arts Council. On September 7th is our hip hop festival, Evolution of Hip Hop. This is the 5th year. And this festival has been interesting because it's called the Evolution of Hip Hop and it really has evolved as a festival over the years. Mm-hmm. And this year, I think we're kind of really focusing back to our roots of making a platform for young people and people who are newer to the music and rap scene to really have a platform and have a chance to get to perform and try performing in front of an audience and being on a public stage. So we're really focusing on that and trying to have a bunch of high school students there and college students and, again, younger people who maybe don't have a platform. And I think in general, there's been a lot of people in the arts community trying to make space for hip hop and rap in Boston. And I think people have done a really good job of that. Oompa's one of those people, but there's many others. Mm-hmm. And we want to make sure we're also making room for newer people who aren't the five names that are really well known at this point. Mm-hmm. And so I think the festival this year will focus a lot on that.
And you're working pretty heavily with Yvette down here at Somerville Media Center.
Exactly. Yvette Wilkes has been, it was her idea originally to do this festival, and her and I have partnered really closely over the years to work on it. And she's really has a really great vision for giving people, especially young people or people who haven't had that chance to have that exposure, opportunity to do that.
Yeah, we love her. She's a power producer here.
Absolutely.
And we're looking forward to this event.
Yeah, so that's September 7th from 3 to 7 p.m. And then the next day, September 8th, there will be two festivals.
Okay.
One in Union Square, which is the Rock and Roll Yard Sale, which is a super fun event. It's a vintage and craft market, lots of records, as the name implies, and live bands. So that's just a super chill, fun Sunday event. And then at the same time at Trump Field will be the Dog Festival. I think this is the 4th or 5th year of this festival, or at least that I've been part of. And there's usually, over 300 dogs and they're humans who come to this festival. And there's activities, there's vendors, there's a play that has dogs as actors.
What?
Yes. Last year they did Princess and the Pea. So I don't know what this year's play is, but it's always interesting. And it's a wild time. And people without pets are welcome to attend. They often do adoptions there as well. So go check out some cute pups. And this year, every year the event is a fundraiser. And this year the event is fundraising for mobile vet services for homeless populations and people who don't have access to financial access to veterinary services or food for their pets. So that's really great. It's a good cause and it's super fun. It's super cute. When you're in the area that day, you just see dogs like streaming into Trump Field. So it's quite a vision.
So if you're a record collector who has a dog on that day, you're really going to be torn.
Luckily, they're both several hour events, so you can do a double header.
Okay, good.
For sure.
Good.
Yeah.
And then does that wrap up September for
There's
you?
There's one more.
Okay, one more.
Yeah, so September 15th is the Highland Ave Summer Street.
Oh, how could I have forgotten that?
Of course. And that's a really fun event. I feel like for us, it ushers in the fall season. Mm-hmm. And we have two stages of music. One of the stages in partnership with Once. They program that stage. We do a stage at the Armory. We have a lot of interactive activities. And Summer Streets, we do four of them every year, as you know. And to me, those are really a chance for community members to come out in their own neighborhoods, connect with each other. The streets shut down, they can just walk around without worrying about cars and construction and things like that.
Yeah.
And it's a really good time. So that's on the 15th from 2 to 6 p.m. And I think we have some really great bands lined up. We're about to announce that lineup, I believe, next week. So you can check out the Arts Council Facebook or website for more information on that.
All right, I'm sure we're going to be checking that, and we hope you all do as well.
Yeah.
As well as checking out all of these events, these late summer, early fall.
Yeah. Oh. How did we get here?
How did we get to early fall already? But we love fall. Fall's a great season.
I'm excited for sweaters.
Leaf peeping.
Totally.
All of that. Cocoa, cider.
I'm ready for the cider.
Well, thank you as always.
Thanks for having
coming
me.
By, Nina, and get out there to these events.
I'll talk to you soon.
Talk to you soon.